Hi everybody, this is my Roomba i7 first day experience video. I will post my other experience video in the coming days. Let's start the first day video. The bigger and heavier box than I expect. Thanks to the double rubble brush system, hair on the floor doesn't get tangled in these brushes. You know, iRobot is a company with over 30 years of robotic expertise and 20 years of robot vacuum manufacturing experience. It's an American brand and the brand was bought by Amazon. Let's check what I have in the box. The robot vacuum itself, one charging station and cord, one extra filter, one extra side brush, two AA size batteries, and one dual mode virtual wall barrier, quick start guide and owner's guide. Please check the iRobot product page for the update box content and the price. It has a camera on the top. It has not lidar sensor, but the cameras is better than lidar sensors because the cameras provide more data than lasers. There are many sensors on it. Light touch sensor, clip sensors, RC oven sensor, floor tracking sensor. There is a handle that I noticed late. It has 1H sweeping brush. The double brush system increases the suction power. It's better than one brush system. Moreover, they are rubber brushes. Improving the brush system instead of the increasing of the suction power allows to you do same cleaning more quietly. The dustbin seems small, but it will enough to me. It has a small but effective looking filter. After removing the filter, you can clean it with water. The buttons on it touch sensitive and have a very nice lighting indicator with colored lights. To operate the robotic vacuum cleaner, you need to have a wireless internet that covers the whole house. Install the iRobot home app and sign up. iRobot home app is a user-friendly application that explains everything with visually. I complete the installation without any difficulties. I waited about 2 hours for it to charge. Then the first thing you need to do is mapping. It goes everywhere it can while mapping. It will be useful for the turn on the lights while mapping. I tried without turning on the lights for some rooms, but it's still successful. It tries to recognize every corner of the house during the mapping phase. It stayed under the bed for a long time. Sometimes it can even get under the carpet. Once it learns the place, it passed and started moving from room to room like a human. The age of the tin rugs are a bit of a problem for it, but it continues on its way. It was able to get under every chair in the house. We closed the door because we didn't want the bathroom mat. It can move the doors little by little. It is usually necessary to close mirrors during mapping, but I didn't close them and there was no wrong mapping. When it returned to the living room, it spent long time under the chairs. It rechecked the corners it couldn't get in its previous lap. After about 1 hour, the robot vacuum returned to the charging station. To complete the mapping, you need to customize the map in the app. First, you need the name of the map and then the rooms. If you want, you can turn the map according to you. Then you need to check the room divisions. Then Roomba i7 is ready to clean room by room. After the mapping was finished, I started to clean the living room at the first suction power. Cleaning details will be in my second video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.